Good morning, everybody. I am here today to show you guys a new tool that I got for my kitchen, and I would really say it's actually a new toy. I went ahead and purchased the new Kitchenaid, or it's a new for me. It's cordless Kitchenaid 7-speed hand mixer. I have been wanting to get a hand mixer for quite a while now, because since I've been doing a lot of baking, sometimes it's just easier and convenient for me to use a hand mixer instead of the stand mixer, especially when I'm making icing or I am making my favorite keto bombs. So anyway, I got this a few months ago, and I finally have the time and energy to do this today. And I've already opened this box a little while ago, and in the box it comes with a few things. Obviously it comes with a mixer, the machine, and with the machine it comes the two whisks attachment, so it comes with two. And then it also comes with a charger, and what I'm doing right now is actually I'm charging it, because I was reading the instruction manual. It's telling me that it has to be charged prior to use. It did not come pre-charged. So anyway, along with that, I got the manual right there and some instructions right here about this wonderful little toy. And also it came with a little pamphlet on things that you can get from KitchenAid. So here we are. If you're noticing, there's a green blinking on the battery area right there. And what it is, I was reading the instructions. The charging status, if it's green, it means it's about 30 to 100% charged. It actually started yellow when I first plugged it in, and the yellow means 15 to 30%, and red means it's lower than 15%. So I'm gonna let this thing charge a little bit more before I use it, because I am planning to make keto bombs this morning, and this is what I'm planning to use as my mixer. So this is the onyx black color, and I actually think it looked like a hair dryer initially when it came out of the box. But I have had different hand mixers in the past. Usually I get the cheap ones that you can get from like CVS or Walgreens, and they don't last me maybe but 3 to 4 or 5 uses, and then it starts to not work anymore. So as I have been doing a lot of baking since the pandemic started, I decided to get me a really nice KitchenAid mixer, hand mixer, since I've been using the other KitchenAid stand mixer. Anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and get the other stuff that I'm gonna be needing. So as I'm reading this, this says that, just gonna tell you more about this. This is a KitchenAid brand's first cordless suite. All the power you expect without the cord, freedom to cook anywhere. And there's not much here on the guide, except that it's telling you how to charge this little gadget, and then what the charging status is. It's also telling you how to insert. It's actually, the beaters are actually stainless steel, okay? And it is controlled, you can control the speed by using the speed controller, which I think this is gonna be the speed controller right there. And to eject the button to release the stainless steel beaters, and you just have this thing, there's that actually, oh yeah, the top one right there, that's to eject this, the beaters. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna unplug this and see if I'm gonna put this beaters on here. See how easy it is. There you go, the other one, and here it is. Oh, it's pretty quiet. So let me go ahead and get the stuff that I'm gonna be needing for my keto bombs, and we'll see how this thing works. So for my keto bombs, I think this is another little instruction to kind of show you guys how I do my keto bombs. It's really mainly because I'm trying to stay keto, and so I make this as my dessert if I'm looking for something sweet. So basically, you put salted I'm actually using salted butter, and this is equivalent to 1 cup. No, this is actually half a cup. Oh my God, I can't even say. It's half a cup of this butter. And this has actually been in room temperature since last night. And my house usually stays in around 70 degrees. So here you go. And then along with that, I have my cream cheese, which is just a regular cream cheese that I got from H-E-B. So the main reason for me of showing you this is I just really want to see what this KitchenAid mixer is going to do and how effective it is as far as mixing all these things together. Because I found out it's very easy for me to stick this in, use my stand-up mixer. But like I said, sometimes I would rather just do the hand mixer because it's easier, faster, and it's really convenient in a way. There you go. So those two things there. And so now what we're gonna do is I'm gonna show you guys with this mixer here. You know what? I am very, very surprised of how quiet this machine is. And I can actually talk to you guys and still hear myself talking. Oh my God, this is really good. And let me try to get the speed up a little higher. Let me get my spatula. Hold on. Really does work. Here it is. Actually, I have to tell you, I am very, very surprised of how quiet this KitchenAid mixer is. Almost all the time, hand mixers tend to have a lot of noise when you're actually using it. But one thing I noticed, sticks could be a little heavy, you know, so if you're gonna be using this for a longer period of time, it might be a little hard on you, especially if you have arthritic hands or wrists. So, but otherwise, I think this is really a nice purchase. And I really did not pay a lot of money for this. I think it was on sale when I got it. I know for sure it was on sale, and I know it's on sale, but I think I paid about $79 for this one. And I had some cash credit with Best Buy. I think I got $20 off of that. So I think in reality, I paid about $50-something for this thing. So I would say at this point, I am liking it, and I know I'm gonna be using this a lot more than probably now my stand mixer. And hopefully this will last me a long time, and definitely I'll let you guys know if for any reason I start having issues with it. So here it is again. This is the cordless hand mixer from KitchenAid. It's 7 speed. So I'm gonna just do the first speed is right here. Second. Third. Fourth. Fifth. Actually that's 5. Sixth. I think as you get to the higher level of speed, it does get a little noisy. However, it's like I said, it's much better than some of the other hand mixers I've used in the past. So there you go. And hopefully this lasts me a long time, like I said, and I'm looking forward to sharing more of the new things that I get and share it to you guys. And I would love to know what you think about it. If you have one of these, give me a shout out. Tell me what you like and don't like about it. Have a good one, everybody. Have a good weekend, and God bless.